And I had a viewer question came in, and I had heard it before, so she kind of got my attention. She said, "Can you do something, do a segment on friends with benefits over 50?" Let's talk about that. Friends with benefits over 50, good or bad idea?
Did you push record?
Thank you so much for tuning in to Second Act TV. Today, I'm so happy to welcome Robert Manny back. Robert, thanks so much for joining me again.
Thanks so much, Silke.
And Robert, of course, is the author of The Guy's Guide to Love, the radio host of Guy's Guide Radio, and you bring that male perspective, to everything we talk about. And I had a viewer question came in, and I had heard it before, so she kind of got my attention. She said, "Can you do something? Do a segment on friends with benefits over 50." And at first I thought, really? are we still in that space? And I threw it into Google like I usually do with topics, see what's out there, and boom. Yeah, this is being written about. This is big. And one of the first articles that came up was actually by Patti Brisben. She is the founder of Pure Romance, a huge company. She pretty much controls the, let's say, the accessory space when it comes to sexuality. And she f actually flew in to interview with me when I first started Second Act. She was a huge supporter. She loved what we were doing. And her position on it was, under no circumstances should you do this, because it's impossible, in her opinion, to separate sex and emotions. And then right after that, under that, an article popped up as a rebuttal to it, also by a woman. I think her name, let me oh, Joan Price. And she is a well-known writer, again, in the ageless sexuality space, who had the opposite view. And I thought, this is a great topic for Robert. Let's talk about that. Friends with benefits over 50, good or bad idea?
I don't think it's over 50 is the issue. A lot of folks over 50 now are experiencing the same situations, an environment they did, but it's updated, that they did when they're in their 20s and 30s and dating, because a lot of people have gone through marriages and they're single and they're looking and they're like, what do I do? The world passed me by. How do I get back out there? There's all this technology, online dating. I don't know if that's icky or not, and I'm not going to do Tinder and all of this stuff. So it's tough for a lot of people and they need some guidance. But the thing that doesn't change is people's values and knowing who they are and what they want and what they have to offer. So when it comes to friends with benefits, if you're 30 or 40 and you're comfortable with friends with benefits, that means having a casual sexual relationship with a friend, and you can manage that without your emotions kind of getting in the way. Then, in my opinion, you're an adult. If you two of you have an understanding, you can do that, fine. However, human nature is, how long does friends with benefits last? I mean, how many people do you know? Not you specifically, Silke, but everybody out there. How many people do we know who are in a friends with benefits relationship or multiple friends with benefit relationships? I don't know too many people who are doing that. It seems like one partner or the other is looking for something more. And there is emotion as part of it. And unless the two people are on the exact same wavelength in terms of expectations from an emotional intelligence standpoint or an understanding about feelings, then there's going to be a problem, because one person, and I would think, I'll go out on a limb and say, usually the woman's going to take more emotion out of the sexual experience, because one, the act itself, a woman is in a different position than the guy for the most part. And I think guys have a more of a conditioning. I'm not saying it's right or wrong to be able to compartmentalize the sexual act. I'm not saying this is right, but a lot of guys would welcome friends with benefits just as a lifestyle, and to a certain point where they feel that, it's kind of empty after a while, that they really want to have something more than that. But I think it's up to the individual. But I think for a lot of ladies out there, friends with benefits at any age is, it's a tough one to kind of master over time and manage, because your feelings are going to get into it. And that's perfectly understandable. My personal feeling is, don't have sex with anybody you don't have any feelings for. If it's just like wham, bam, and that's all you want to do, okay, I understand. And maybe that happens. You're out. You had a couple too many margaritas or whatever, and you're into the other person. But, you know, over time, you start doing that. There is an exchange of energy when you have sex. And if you don't feel anything, there's something wrong with that, in my opinion. It just doesn't work for me. I've never gone to bed with a woman who I didn't like. And I have some feelings for it, some one way or the other. Now, we may not have stayed together after that, but I was into them as a person, and that was part of the sexual sharing and experience. That's just me. So to me, friends with benefits, if you can make it work and it's something you're comfortable with, okay. But I think it's kind of tough to do that, regardless of your age, for an ongoing friendship type of situation.
Yeah. I think one of the reasons, and I agree with everything you just said, and for the most part, I agree with everything both Patti and Joan wrote as well.
I can see that, and there's no
judgment. But thinking about it, like for me, I don't think it could work because, as you said, to separate emotion from sex is impossible for me. I think that one of the reasons that this is a topic for our age, or especially for women, when you're starting over again, you're. I think Patti made that point too. You're kind of testing the waters to see, do I still have it? You know, and maybe mm-hmm. by with somebody who's actually a friend, there's some comfort there or some safety or something. Because to me, you know, casual sex and friends with benefits are two different things. Yeah, you can go out, you can, as you said, go have some margaritas, maybe somebody you met or whatever. That to me is casual sex, not a friends yep. with benefit. Mm-hmm. This would right. be somebody I know, maybe you knew him a while back, you get, you know, there's never, you're not quite sure if there's that attraction, but you're friends and you're having sex. And that is, I think that's really difficult, complicated to handle.
I agree with you. I think people have to think it through. If you want to just test yourself out, do I still have it? I don't think friends with benefits is the way to do that, because you're going to open up another can of worms, another set of potential issues where, okay, you still have it. You're still attractive or whatever it is that you're trying to prove to yourself. But now you're in a situation where you're having sex with a friend. And is that going to complicate or detract from your friendship? Is that going to grow into a relationship? What is the other person's expectations? To me, you know, if you can manage it, great. I mean, everybody's an adult, and to me, there's not enough love in the world. So if there's love there and people, you know, just human love, feel like, hey, we really dig each other, but we want to stay friends for various reasons, and we like to have sex. Okay, do it if you can handle that. It's challenging. For guys, I think a lot of guys, including myself, when I was single, could I have friends with benefits? Hell yeah, did I? I had some, but, you know, ultimately, I don't know if all of the women I was having friends with benefits were thinking we're just having friends with benefits one-on-one. I don't think they would particularly approve of multiple friends with benefits situations, where I think a lot of guys could handle, could say, hey, I know all these beautiful women, I'm friends with them, we have sex. You know, that sounds like a pretty good deal to most guys.
Yeah, I think, and we're starting to, you know, get here, we have a few minutes left. I think especially at our age, I can see a situation where, you know, we've lived a long time. I don't want to get married again. You know, I really like you, Robert. I do I want to be with you every day? No, but, you know, I can mm-hmm. kind of see you. That. Mm-hmm. I can kind of see that, where that would be actually different than if you were younger, because you're settling into some sort of, you know, right. later in life situation. For me, still, I don't know. I think you really need to ask yourself, what is it that I really want? And is this...
So, you know, so we're going to just stay friends and no benefits.
No, we're not going to... Yeah, well...
Well, you know what? The benefit of the friendship is just knowing you. So, and that's that, you know, that's something that's true. If you have a friend and you really dig them, you don't have to have sex with them. If the two of you really feel like you want to have sex, well, then it's up to you. Whatever works, really. And as you know, when you've gone through, people over 50 have gone through a lot of life situations and learned a lot of life lessons. And if that's something that they know how to handle, and for whatever various reasons and external factors there are there, and they can pull it off, more power to them.
Yeah. No, like I said, no judgment. It's an interesting topic, and I'd love to hear, you know, I'm looking forward to the comments we get on this, and please share your experiences. And if, you know, others in this situation, do you have some wise words? You know, we'd love to hear it. We usually get some pretty long blogs under these videos, and I love it. Is there anything else you want to add before we close out this segment, Robert?
Well, I always say there's not enough love in the world. So whoever you have sex with, have some type of feelings, because there is an exchange of energy. And the first person you want to love and respect before anybody else is yourself. So be good to yourself. Love yourself.
Yeah, no, that's great, great, great words. And I think maybe that's one of the reasons I wanted to do the segment too. It's that you don't want to create a situation where you create more hurt, because, you know, we've had enough of that already. So anyway, great talking with you, Robert. We'll see you soon again on Second Act TV.
All right. Thank you, Silke. Bye, everybody.
Thanks for watching, and please be sure to subscribe to our channel. The button is right over here. Just click on through to YouTube, and when you see the little bell right next to the subscribe button, hit that too. We'll notify you every time we launch a new video. See you next time.